Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Ken, and I will be your MC for this afternoon. As you can see, I am a fisherman. My boat is in dry dock at the moment. Actually, it's stuck on the rocks in the bay. I took this gig so I could pay to have it removed and brought back. But I was just told this is a volunteer job. Go figure, eh? Please sit back and enjoy a bit of foolishness, and please laugh at our jokes. I'm not sure I believe in fortune tellers or psychics, but some people will spend their hard-earned money on anything.
I see a woman coming, and she has a big red nose. Oh no, sorry, that's my reflection. Let me try again. Come in, Gary.
I'm impressed already, you know my name.
Oh, I saw him coming in through the window.
My goodness.
What can I do for you, Gary?
Oh, I was hanging around with a lot of the BOAA golfers, those old gents, and we were talking about what it would be like in the afterlife. And I figured I saw your sign, the best way in to you, a psychic, is to ask a question to someone who knows all.
So what will it be like in the afterlife?
I know all and I can see all, Gary.
Awesome.
Now, I see that there are many, many golf courses in heaven, and they're beautiful.
Amen.
Absolutely beautiful. But I'm sorry, there's good news and there's bad news.
There's bad news?
Yeah. So the good news is that they're beautiful golf courses, but the bad news is your tee off time's 8:30 tomorrow. Morning.
$50,
please.
$50, I'm going tomorrow. At least I don't have to worry about the money anymore, do I?
No, thank you.
Well, thank you. Sure.
Come in, Cherry. $50, and that entitles you to three questions.
I have to ask the questions, but nobody told me that, and I didn't think of any last night. I mean, how am I going to come up with questions? What are the questions about?
Well, Sherry, they can be about anything.
And you charge $50 for that? For three questions? Isn't that a bit much?
Well, maybe. Now, Sherry, what is your third question?
You have got to be kidding me.
Not at all. Oh, no. I should have seen that coming. You know what? Never in a headline will you ever see something that says, "The psychic is going to win Catch the Ace."
COVID has been a long haul for some. Here is Sherry to reflect on the effects of the past couple of years.
I am so glad all those restrictions are over, especially those masks. You never could tell who I was talking to, but I developed these thoughts, and well, they keep running around in my head, and I can't get rid of them. I'm not crazy, but I just thought I could come here and give them all to you to take home. So, number one, I wrote them down so I could keep my memory straight. Oh, my mic. See, I told you I'd forget something. There's supposed to be a button. Oh, there's the button. Now is it on? Oh, boy, yay! Number one. Did anyone get anything? Like a tan from the fridge? I sure got that and some. And another thing was my dog.
You're in front
we
of
were
the
only
camera.
There about a month. Well, he came and he sat down and he looked up at me with his very sad, sorrowful eyes. Now you see why I tear up the furniture. And I was sitting there playing solitaire on a Friday night, and I suddenly realized the trash goes out more than I do. And then there was my neighbor, who used to come over for coffee on my porch, 6 feet apart, and a mask, but he came. He wanted to tell me what a great blessing being home with his wife during COVID was. They have caught up on everything that he's done wrong for the last 20 years. He doesn't come over much now. But on a really good, positive, happy note, I just sold my beautiful homing pigeon on eBay for the 22nd time.
I would now like to introduce a Patsy Cline wannabe.
Thank you.
ask her for her phone number later.
Okay, back to the show. For those of us who have struggled with learning the complex and frustrating... Anyway, for those of us who have struggled with learning the computer, complex and frustrating systems of the computer, either for work or personal use, there was an interesting experiment that we would like to share with you now.
Dance to, and your grandparents, and probably even some great grandparents. Anyways, I'm going to give you a few samples. We're going to go way, way back, grandparents' time, 1892. After the ball is over, Polly took out her glass eye, put her false teeth in some water, hung up her wig to dry, put her false arm on the table, laid her false leg on the chair. After the ball was over, Bonnie was only half there. We'll be back with more great hits from this brand new compilation.
We take you now to a local watering hole where the men go to ask silly questions and complain, mostly about their wives.
Hey guys, do you think marriage is a lottery?
I think marriage is a lottery. No, with a lottery at least you have a slight chance of winning.
What about times gone by? Let's talk about the internet. How did people ever release the boredom of the internet? What do you think they did,
Doug? Well, I'm really not too sure. But then I asked my 26 brothers and sisters. They didn't know either.
Well, that would do it.
Cheers.
My beautiful and sexy wife dresses to kill. Sadly, she cooks the same way.
Oh, man. My wife and I were happy for 20 years. Then we met.
Well, a good wife always forgives her husband, especially when she's wrong.
Well, I was married by a judge. I should have asked for a jury. By the way, how did you like the fortune teller skit?
Oh, I thought it was okay. It's right on the mark, I thought. Yep.
I went to a psychic once. I knocked and she yelled, "Who is it?" So I left.
I bought my wife a new car. I got a phone call on the cell phone and she said, Dear, there's water in my carburetor. What should I do? I said, Where are you? She said, "In the lake." So that's right.
Oh, I love being married. It's great to know that you can spend the rest of your life living with somebody you could get annoyed.
Perfect.
My wife and I were at a dancing hall the other night, and she said to me, "Look at that drunk guy dancing over there." Of course, I said, "Who is it?" She said, 10 years ago, he proposed to me and I rejected him. Oh my God, he's still celebrating. I say, never go to bed mad. Stay up and fight. Oh well, that's life. Time for another round, guys.
I'm the designated driver. Just one word to the gentleman in the crowd about this marriage thing. The old philosopher said, "Men who fight with wife all day get no peace at night."
Amen to that. Next up is Trish. Not sure just what she's performing today for you. Let's give her a warm welcome.
Gee, I'm so nervous. I was just in the green room thinking how I got to this position. Then I remembered a couple of months ago we had a meeting and someone put up their hand and said, let's do a variety show. Me not paying attention, so they said variety store. So I immediately put up my hand, count me in. So here I am on stage with no talent. I heard playing the spoons could be easy. I once heard my mom tell a tale when she was young. She fell in love with theater when a gentleman played the spoons in her town hall. So let me try it. See? No talent. Maybe I can sing for you. My parents and myself, when we were very young, would sit outside in the summer and sing along with Mitch Miller. Until one evening, my dad said, maybe you should be the bouncing ball. I'm looking over a 44.
No! We don't want to wake the dead.
See? No talent. I love the ballet. So I thought maybe I could dance for you. So I signed up for a class. I went to the class and I was amazed how many people were so tall and so thin. Anyway, after a quick workout, somebody said, let's go to the bar. I thought, great, I really could do with a drink after this. That's not what they meant. They meant the bar, you know, the one in front of the mirrored wall? So anyway, I went to the bar and I realized I'm very short and the bar was very tall. I got my feet up on there, but I couldn't get them down. But it took three handsome men that were very muscular and very tight tights to get me down. Oh, that was an amazing day. But that was the last of my dance classes. So anyway, I'll show you what I learned.
We don't want to scare the dead either.
This is wrong, Sean, too. Anyway, next year I will just go to the grind store. Ciao.
Now, please welcome Norma.
Fireman's Ball.
account. Please welcome Norma to give us a different meaning to getting older. Norma.
Hi, everyone. I want to say thanks to Ken. By the way, you're doing a wonderful job as MC today. Isn't he, everybody? I am going to talk about a new alphabet. When we were kids, we all learned A is for apple, B is for ball, C is for cat. I forget what comes next. However, now that I am older, I discovered a new alphabet for us. A is for arthritis. B is for bad back, we all know. C is for cancer or cardiac. D is for diabetes and decline. E is for eyesight. I can't even read the top line. F is for fluid retention. G is for gas, which I'd rather not mention. H is for high blood pressure. I'd rather have low. I like this one. I is for incision, because I have a few of these. I is for incision with scars you can't show. J is for joints that fail to flex. L is for libido. Whatever happened to sex? Oh, wait, I forgot one. K. K is for my knees, the crack when bent. M is for memory. Mine ain't worth a cent. N is for neurosis, pinched nerve and stiff neck. O is for osteoporosis and all the bones that crack. P is for prescriptions, of which I have a few. Give me a pill and then I'll be as good as new, guys. Q is for queasiness. Is it fatal or is it just the flu? R is for reflux. When one meal turns into two. C is for sleepless nights. Oh, I can sleep. Counting all my fears. T is for tinnitus when I hear bells in my ears. U is for urinary difficulties with flow. V is for vertigo. That's dizzy, you know. W is for worry. Now I wonder what's going around. X is for x-ray. I wonder what they found. Y is for another year that I've left behind. Last but not least, zest. Z is for zest. And at least I still have my mind.
The doctor is not always pleasant, but sometimes it can surprise you.
Potatoes and dinner tonight.
Wow, he used to be a money rabbit one time, but boom, it stopped. A pill? Which pill is it?
find it. Oh, no, here it is, right here. It's really wonderful. Good luck.
And just mix it in his potatoes?
That's right.
And that's it?
That's right. And you get to stand by for the best results.
I can already wait. Thank you, doctor. Bye.
It just
is awesome blue. So browse the web, have Max take up crochet. Wait, the times are changing as I sit here. Vaccinations worked, we can go out. Time to find if any clothes still fit me. Time to meet my friends without a screen. Pre-COVID days, my friends, have now come back again. Oh, how I love to travel, dine, and shop. I'm not content to stay. No, oh, I'm out to play. Pre-COVID day, oh, freedom's back again. La, la.
Thank you.
years, Judy kept us sane. We were able to do radio plays, and it was wonderful. We had laughs, and so thank you.
You're welcome.
Enjoy them, okay? And then you